You know you're in for a treat when mac and cheese is on the menu. But there's mac and cheese and then there's Adam's four cheese mac and cheese.
Yeah.
Which is what we're making today. Wow, like
this is a nice arrangement, isn't it? Nice cheeses here for us.
I love mac and cheese. It's lush, it's creamy, it's gooey. It's everything you want in a sometimes meal, I guess. You don't have it every day, definitely not.
Yeah, no, no way. But you know what? I thought, you know, let's just take it to another level. All these cheeses. So gorgonzola, asiago, mascarpone, parmesan, and then, you know, normally it has some form of ham in it. So I did the pancetta, but we're going to do a little trick with that pancetta.
Okay,
yeah,
course.
So, look, we're using the macaroni here from San Remo. Mm-hmm. So I need to get that on the go straight away.
I'll open that.
All right, good pinch of salt into the pot, a bit more. Like you said, this is not one you'd have every day,
no.
But a nice little treat.
It is, and I guess if you're going to treat yourself with mac and cheese, you don't have a bowl this big.
No.
You have a small amount of it, because it's very rich, isn't it?
Well, if you're greedy like me, a couple of bowls, I
reckon. Okay, okay, a couple of bowls. Today we're allowed to.
So, sauce. I need to get that on the go.
Right. Do you want me to grate some parmesan for
Love
you?
Love you to, yes, that'd be great. So I'm going to get my pan on about medium heat with some butter in first. So at room temperature, nice and soft. So it's full of all those wrong things, you know, like butter and lots of cheese and more butter because I feel like it.
Adam, so look, everything in moderation, I say.
Yeah, definitely. So look, the gorgonzola
is
really smelly and bluey.
But there's gorgonzola picante, which is stronger than the. Is that this is the dolce one?
The dolce, yeah. So this is a. So picante means nice and sharp. So it's got this real sharpness to it, which is the blue, the actual mold in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then the dolce is a little bit sweeter, a bit more toned down, so not creamier. Mm-hmm. So I melt that butter, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the pan off the heat, and I'm going to add this into there, okay? And the reason why, it's going to split.
Okay.
Because of the cheese and the amount of fat. So anything with, obviously, fat in it and all that, once it hits heat, it's going to split.
Mm-hmm.
So we just want to basically try and eliminate the amount of splitting that it's going to do.
And so that's just gently melting
just
it.
Just gently, gently.
It smells so good.
If you see that, look at all that fat and all that beautiful flavour from
Don't
the cheese.
Don't say that.
I know, but you know what? It's a treat dish, all right?
It's a treat dish, yep.
Okay, so the gorgonzola's melted down, nice and gooey.
Yum.
Next, the cream into there.
So the whole lot?
Yeah, the whole lot.
Okay. It is one whole packet, so.
Yeah. So this is going to feed a family of four
as
main course, or maybe six to eight as an entree. So there's plenty of it. Now back onto the heat, just heat that up a little bit. Parmesan now that you grated into there.
Is that enough?
It's plenty.
Just so thought, not enough.
We can always add more, don't worry about that.
Of course, yes.
Okay.
Okay, parmesan in.
In we go. I'll give this one a stir. Now, our next cheese.
Next cheese. So what's this one? This is a...
That's a taleggio.
Taleggio. And we just take off the...
Yeah, you just trim off that rind on the outside.
Just that rind, yeah.
But look how, like, it's so soft, the taleggio. And it's another real full, creamy cheese, you know, like it's got lots and lots of load of flavour in there. But once it melts down into this sauce and the pasta clings onto it...
I love taleggio.
Now, I'm going to get the other pan on, just slowly. And the reason why we're getting this one on, this is our, you know, I was talking about the ham component in mac and cheese. So we're using pancetta today. I'm just going to get that on low. Okay, so we're going to dice this up. We're just going to sweat it off in our pan just to let all that natural fat come out of there and crispen it up. And then we're going to mix it with the breadcrumbs and crumble it over the top for our mac and cheese. And bake it in the oven so we get this crunchy texture.
Love it.
So you want to dice that or I'm going to do it?
You can do that.
Okay, chef, no problems. Pieces.
I love when you just can get a piece, a big chunky piece like that because you can cut it to the way you like. Sometimes it can be cut quite thin.
Yep.
But if you can get a big slab just like that, keep it in the fridge. It lasts longer too when it's left whole.
Definitely.
Can we take over?
Yeah, I will because I want to watch my sauce. I want to make sure that the sauce is not catching on the sides because it has a high fat content with all those cheeses and the cream in there.
Is that enough pancetta? A little bit more. That's enough?
If you want some more, look.
Yeah, just a touch more for good luck.
So look, into the pan, and that was just on low, and you can hear that sizzle already just happening. Keep moving around. So I like to put a little bit of a layer between the pasta. I like rapini, rape. So it's an Italian broccoli. It's a bit of a wild scenario, like, you know, it's grown on the side of the roads and we pick it and we boil it a lot because it's quite stalky and it's quite, how do you say, stringy. So you need to boil it a fair amount, like boil it out.
Right,
So if you can't get hold of it, obviously it's a winter veggie.
Yeah.
Things like your kale or some baby spinach.
Silver beet would work quite nicely.
Cabbage would be nice in there. And just put that through the middle of the pasta. Yeah. And that way it forms, so when you're cracking into it, getting this beautiful cream and this greeniness and this nice crunch on top.
I think it's a wonderful idea, really. And it's just that cuts through that richness, just that little layer makes such a difference, which is quite nice.
And you can tell yourself then it's healthy.
Exactly. There's nothing wrong with having spoiling yourself sometimes, really.
No.
I will do this once a month, one of these dishes, for sure. Easy. Maybe two, maybe three times. Depending on what the occasion is, I say. All right, well, let's wait for that to get a bit of colour. That's going to thicken, and we can strain that and bring it all together.
Okay, Justine, our pasta's cooked. Mm-hmm. Our pancetta's nice and crispy. All I'm going to do is add the breadcrumbs into there.
Okay.
And it's just going to catch on to all the beautiful flavour in there. I'm just going to give them a little flick. Last one here, we need to add some cracked pepper and our mascarpone as well.
Mascarpone straight into there?
Straight into there. Right. So mascarpone, again, high in the fat content, obviously being a cheese. Mm-hmm. Now, we're just going
to
take
so
this.
So you've left that to the end because you don't want it to split.
Yeah. Mascarpone is a little bit temperamental when it comes to the heat. A lot temperamental, to be honest.
It is, yeah.
So if we just work that around, and I'm just going to add it into the pasta, like so.
Oh, cheesy goodness.
All right, I'll get you to mix that for me.
My pleasure. I would love to do that for you.
And I'm just toasting off the breadcrumbs as well here with that pancetta, and it's just latched onto all the flavour in there.
And I guess it's going into the oven, so you don't have to get it golden brown at this stage. You probably don't want it to.
No, you don't. Like I said, 200 degrees, that will crispen up, give our golden colour. So I've hit the heat off on that now. Mm-hmm. Our macaroni's all nice and...
I can't take my eyes off it, it's just too good.
Okay, into a baking dish. So you want to put half the amount on the base first.
Okay, shall we hold both sides like that? And we can easily pour it in. So half of that.
Yeah.
So, like so.
And then don't forget our greeny bit, you know.
Of course. Just balancing it, the whole thing out.
Hey, look at the colours.
Yeah, it looks great. It's good if you want to tell the kids, no, it's just the macaroni cheese.
All right, let's finish this off. So second part on top.
On top. I think it's going to fit.
I hope so.
There we go.
Beautiful. Okay, then to finish, I'm just literally a pancetta and breadcrumbs over the top. There we go. Into the oven. We're looking between, say, 10 to 15 minutes, probably more on the 10-minute side. You've got a nice high oven, golden brown.
200 degrees. Okay, yeah. Fantastic. I'll put that in there for you. So our four cheese macaroni bake is ready to go. We've just allowed it just to cool slightly, obviously, so we don't burn our mouths. And you can see how it's just lightly golden on top, which is perfect.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
I'm very happy with that. I think we should have a try.
Okay.
Oh, yum.
It's going to get everywhere, you know this.
That's all right.
This is a chef's worst nightmare just then, but it's okay.
Get some of the green...
Yeah, look at it.
...kale in there.
And one more for good luck. That is good.
It's so much better with four cheeses. It just makes everything better. And I love gorgonzola.
You pick it up straight away,
you can pick it up straight away. So that, I'm forgetting about two cheeses, three cheeses. From now on, every time I make my mac and cheese, it's four cheeses, Adam style.